It's a Wally Jolly Christmas.
And we are celebrating in the very, very hot Cozumel, Mexico.
It is so hot.
We're ready for a day of adventures here in Cozumel, so let's go. You make everything feel like it's Christmas. Everything that I'm with you. Everything that I'm with you.
Ready for pinatas and chocolate, honey? The port adventure. Green had this really great observation that they have the Preludes bar open, but all they're really selling is waters in six packs and coolers and stuff to take ashore. All right, deck one forward. Time to get off the ship.
All right. Here we go, down the pier. Bye, Disney Magic, we'll be back. We're off on an adventure.
All right, now we're loading into the taxi vans.
Now to make the chocolate, we need to take out from the pot, from the hard shell, all the beans. And in this picture, you can see the texture of the mucilage. The white bulb is sticky and slimy, totally white. And if you want to take out the bulb by your hands, it's not easy. That's why we need to ferment our beans, and that's how we can separate the pulp from the bean. And in the fermentation, the sugar that we have from the white pulp turns into alcohol. And then you can make an alcoholic drink without alcohol. And in the other side, you have the cocoa bean, a wet bean. The next process, we need to dry the bean. Our bean is ripe when we have the last color, which is the red color. Kind of red. Mm-hmm. The same bean changes its color from a white until a red. I gave you this bean because I want to explain you, I want to let you know, this is how was the currency long time ago. And right now, I'm going to share this bean already roasted, and I want you to compare this with the one before. The second bean I gave you is easy to peel it. Just twist with your finger and take it out from the shell. Then you can have the cocoa bean. Right now, if you want to taste the cocoa leaves, you can taste it, but it's so bitter.
How's the bean?
If you want, all the Mayans make their chocolates. They grow those beans, the same bean that I already gave you, in the stones. Because you can see how the same bean I gave you is turning into a paste. And this is the cocoa bean I just grown, and they prepare a bean with that chocolate, the hot chocolate. This chocolate just members of the leaf. For example, if you are an emperor, you can drink the chocolate many times. If you are a prince, the same. But the rest of the population, if they want to drink it, they need to die before. For example, if you are the lucky one to be sacrificed, you can have the opportunity to taste the chocolate. And then you die and hasta la vista, baby. That was chocolate. The beginning of the chocolate. When the Spaniards came to Mexico, we were all the Mexicans who were conquered by the Spaniards. They noticed that this hot chocolate was very important for our people, so they were wondering, what is that? I want to taste it. They taste the chocolate and they say, I feel good after this. I feel energetic because when you eat a good chocolate, you feel good. But they say, this is bitter. We want the sugar. They bring us from Europe the cane plant, and since that moment in Mexico we produce cane sugar. They also bring us the cinnamon tree, and since that moment we have cinnamon, which is a bark from the tree. And that's how they change the chocolates, because now they make the chocolate in this shape, like this. We call it the chocolate abuelita. Abuelita means the little grandma. And that's the most traditional chocolate we have in Mexico to drink.
That cinnamon smells really good. You're not gonna share, are you?
It's not bad, it's better. I'm making it.
cupcakes in vanilla. Oh yeah, that's much better. This one, oh, this is a cactus.
Not bad.
So we snap it here.
What's
snap
the
it
difference?
By you
guys. The one before?
I hope you heard that snap.
It's sweeter. It's also creamy. Cactus makes the chocolate sweeter and creamy. Makes it taste like a milk chocolate.
Yeah, it does.
It's not a milk chocolate.
That's crazy. Here she comes with the chile chocolate.
Take a minute.
Going all in on that.
You hear anything? Is it speaking to you?
Let me see. Okay. Chocolate with chili.
Came to the Stingray Beach. Wally had to get a ray. Of course he did, huh?
Yep. And
now it's pretty cute.
He's part of the family.
Now he's part of the Ray family, yeah?
And the baby.
And the baby, I know.
There she is, the magic. Let's head on down, get back on the ship.
On the ship, Wally's
ready to go to the pool. But first, we gotta deliver our ornaments. I really love these. They are so fun. We didn't make these ones, but we did buy them from a small shop that's in the the Disney group on Facebook for people that were displaced during the pandemic. So, deliver. And then we'll go up to the pool.
Well, back up on deck, we did duck dining.
Pepperoni pizza from Pinocchio's.
Gluten free.
Yeah, and then I went and got a taco from Cabana's because I saw people with them and they looked so good. And some olives and Gouda and some shrimps.
Yep.
Why not?
Wally had to do chickies.
Chicky tenders.
What's this?
Jello. And he got a strawberry cookie ice cream sundae.
How is that, buddy? And I got the hookup. Look at this. This is a barbecued pulled pork sandwich. All good. Lunch is over. A good motivator for Wally to go swimming and do the slide. You have to eat all your food. Man, does he shovel it in very quick then. So here he goes down the slide. Daddy, you survived! What'd you think, Dad? Alright, well, Daddy's verdict is it's super fast and scary. Daddy, you think Wally should do it? I think that Wally says no. Daddy says it's pretty fast and scary. Well, it is a really good pool day. Daddy says he is all done with that water slide. Look at that mark on his back there. Those are angel wings. They're gonna go do the yellow slide now. And you say no, you're not gonna do the aqueduct? I don't care. That's probably smart, buddy. Yeah. That's okay. You and Daddy go do the yellow slide. That's more fun anyway. Okay. All right. Well, they're gonna recover with the round. The yellow slide. There's Wally and Daddy going up. Cause Wally says this one is way more fun. Woo! Here goes Daddy. It's a fast slide. Just talked to the crew. They've alerted the captain to all these pirates on the ship. Captain Jack!
How are you guys doing?
We're great.
What happened to your eye?
With him, you never know.
You never know.
He's very yeah.
Quite the smallest pirate I've ever seen. Quite the average.
Thank you. Various places. Yes. Tortuga, you know.
Yes, they do have the finest clothes.
Ah,
also
and any rum there?
Well, it's not always fresh.
There should be. Yes.
This is all gone.
Yes.
Because I've been there.
I know I've been somewhere. Or maybe because I've been there.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that why it's all here now?
Yes.
None of it.
Is this Chippendale?
This is Chippendale.
And I'm in the right line. Yes. There's my winch. Oh, there they are!
Oh my goodness!
Grandma made those outfits.
Yeah, Grandma made those outfits for you guys. Yes.
She even got teeny tiny.
Look at the teeny tiny brass anchor buttons.
Dale, you have shoes. I have never seen you with shoes on. Maybe we need to try and have some shoes.
Yes. Who would have thought?
But that's fine. But we've got a lovely star patch there on those cute buttons. Oh my goodness. This is amazing. So you know which one is Chip and which is Dale, right? Who's that? Dale. And Dale. We've got our two Dales. Oh, okay. Oh, Chip is hiding Dale. Chip is Chip. Where did Dale? Oh, here he goes. Oh my goodness. How cool is that?
Those chipmunks are so silly.
Three of these here. One more. Five of those. Good.
What is that? Don't touch it. Don't take his gold. Oh, you don't want to take that monster's gold. I'll swallow your soul.
Of course, I can trade a pin.
You want to trade a pin for his gold?
Okay. Like Indiana Jones.
You
gotta do it fast.
Fast. Oh!
Did it work?
No. He's not swallowing your soul. Ahoy, me mateys, look at all the pirates. Okay, this guy might win the costume of the night. He's a parrot to pirate night. Yeah, that wins. In a boat of pirates, we've got one parrot.
The boat of pirates, be a parrot.
Be a parrot. Stand out among the crowd. Watch out behind you, Wally. You got Mr. Smee, although if we go tick-tock, tick-tock.
Uh-oh. We don't say that one.
You gonna throw me over, Captain?
Just the book.
Oh, just the book. Oh, okay. That's his book, though. He's on your side. He is on your side. I'm the mutinous one, Captain. You're watching me. Okay. I got that. Yes. She is a pirate queen.
You do a TikTok to Captain Hook, he's gonna steal your...
Oh, she's the pirate queen. Yes.
He's the queen of his pirates.
Yeah.
He's been known to do things like that.
Oh. Oh, see? Yes, the scallywag's getting thrown overboard. Yep.
Come here, kiddos.
Tonight we're doing dinner at Animator's Palette. It's so black and white in here. I hope that changes. All right, first round has arrived. Wally got chicken noodle soup.
Oh, that's a good chicken noodle soup too.
And Irene and I both got the salmon tartare.
I'm proud of Mark for being adventurous.
I'm gonna be adventurous on this one, guys. Mine is dairy free. You can see Irene's has some
little cream on there,
yeah. That's okay. And whatever this sauce is, it was mayonnaise and garlic.
And paprika.
I can have it, so here goes nothing to you.
Pretty good.
There's Irene's great wreath.
It's so pretty.
Rum and something else.
Saint-Germain.
Oh yeah, Saint Germain.
And pineapple.
Yep. Yeah. And I can't remember what mine was called, the blueberry licious. It's basically like a blueberry margarita.
Yeah.
Basically. Wally's meal has arrived. Have you tried the pizza tonight?
Something different.
Yeah. Irene has got the, what was that?
It's the bacon cheddar potato soup.
Bacon cheddar potato soup.
And I have a sleeping pirate on my lap. He's out.
And I got the chicken and something arugula with raspberry.
Chicken walnut.
Chicken walnut, yep. Yep. Okay, well, Irene got the tuna.
Tuna
steak.
Looks
look at
really
that.
Good.
That looks amazing. And I got the moo cow steak. Ooh. We'll cut into it, but if that thing is actually medium rare, it's gonna be good. Look at that. Order it medium rare on the ship if this is what you want it to look like. Here we go, Ralph's back with the trick. Wait a minute.
All right, Ralph.
Ready? How's he do that?
That's pretty amazing.
That's party.
That's pretty amazing.
It's me, your old pirate pal, Mickey Mouse. Our Pirates in the Caribbean party is about to start, and I just wanted to tell you that no matter what happens tonight, I'm on your side.
Celebration really needs is a great book. And
Now your hands will hug. Hug, you fools!
I got a sundae. What'd you order?
It's the like hazelnut chocolate mousse.
Then from shore we brought with a lovely mini bottle of Cabernet. Partake out here on the veranda.
Perfect way to end the night.
Yes it is. Wally's inside partaking in his dessert, watching cartoons. Well, we enjoy a quiet evening, watching the waves go by.